And hello again. Welcome to the Mr. Stock and Mr. Poe Show. I'm Mr. Stock, and today...
And I'm Mr. Poe.
That's right. What we do most of the time is introduce you to entertaining and interesting people who live here in South Florida, and today's no exception.
Well, one out of two ain't bad.
Which one?
Sure. I don't know. Are they going to be entertaining or interesting?
We'll find out.
One or the other, I can guarantee.
Okay. Right. Well, let's meet one of the entertaining ones, and the other one is what?
One will be interesting, and one will be entertaining.
Okay. Well, we'll first start with Mr. Baker. I'm taking a guess here. Oh, they're both on the screen anyway. Greg Baker.
Taking a guess.
With the bandana on, and the Beast. Should I call you Mr. Beast? Is that okay?
The Beast.
Sir Beast.
I am the Beast.
Sir Beast.
I have a whole list of things you can call him, but
thank you.
Don't call him at home.
Well, you two guys
on television.
Now have a partnership.
Is this television?
Yeah, what is this?
Oh, holy moly, I'm sorry.
Excuse me.
Yeah, stand up your eye.
Sorry.
Okay, that's okay. Ready now.
That's okay.
Makeup. I need makeup if anybody does, huh?
Get those Pulp Fiction glasses off, Poe.
What are you going to do? What do you mean Pulp Fiction glasses?
Pulp Fiction glasses, a resurgence back to the 60s.
Who wears
by them? Hollywood yuppies.
Who wears these glasses? You're like dull.
You're a yuppie. You're
I would have brought a silly hat. Hey,
if
I knew this was like a religious thing where you have to cover
Pulp
your
Fiction.
Head or something.
What are we doing to the show? You got to calm down,
how
man.
How do you know somebody wears glasses like
check
this
those
in
mic
Pulp Fiction? Have you seen the movie? Have you seen the movie?
That was our producer.
You guys need to make up.
You have?
Yes, I have.
You guys need to make
up. It was forced on me, but John Travolta just makes me want to...
I think Mr. Stock has a question.
Hey, I'm in charge here.
Mr. Stock has a question.
Yes, sir.
Now that you've seen it, it's a pretty good
movie. What would you like to ask, Mr. Stock?
Well, since we only have a few minutes with you, because then we have another guest, and Alexa.
Right, she's much prettier than us, right, Majika?
Get us out.
Well, Mr. Poe wants me to be funny, but I don't want to be funny.
You need to be funny, Mr. Stock.
I want to ask...
You weren't very funny in the last show.
People who don't know who Greg...
Oh, a little dissension in the ranks, boys.
I don't know who I am.
No, Greg Baker. I've admired your writing for years, since the Miami News. In fact, you used to write articles about my folk music concerts.
Pink Edition.
I've admired your folk music concerts and your show.
Why don't you just go off and make love somewhere, you two, all right?
I kind of suspected this.
Mr. Stock has a question.
I have a question. What happened to you in the New Times? You're not there anymore.
What happened to
Miami
News? I don't know what happened to them. Yeah, it's been months, I guess, now.
You were one of the only people who really had guts to write four-letter words in that newspaper.
Well, we're going to put a stop to that, damn it. No dancing, no drumming, no smoking, no eating, no drinking.
No thinking.
And no four-letter words.
No rock and roll.
So that's what happened? They started censoring you? Is
more rock and roll? No, not really. They were just headed in a different direction. I mean, you can read the paper and be a judge of that. Okay. Plus, I'd been in print, like you said, 12 years. Tired, man.
Yeah. Well, okay, well, ask Mr. Sir Beast.
Anymore,
I have a question for you relating to this.
Yes.
It was a brilliant move for you to get Greg to be a partner with you with your endeavors, but now that he doesn't have the New Times, why don't you dump him?
Well,
my agent.
I was thinking of bringing in China Valish as my partner, but I decided to leave him alone, and I picked the lowest possible denominator, Greg Baker.
Me Kimba.
Me Diane Ray.
Well, you guys are known as Beast and Baker.
We are.
And you do a radio program.
We do. On a radio station.
On Waxy 790.
790.
Well, if you don't want to promote it, that's okay with me.
Typical DJs.
Saturday nights at midnight.
Well, there is no such thing as DJs anymore.
And there's nothing typical
about Waxy
either.
We're the only DJs left in the whole world. No, it's homogenized and pasteurized.
And we have to be careful because we're in constant fear of the FUCC coming in and shutting us down because we present ideas that maybe aren't presented.
Well,
like
homogenized and pasteurized.
Right. What we tell the FUCC to do is take whatever complaints they have. Take it on over to the Dade County Trash Dump at Mount Trashmore, and stick it right in!
See, and we say things
really
like that,
feel?
So we live in constant
how do you
fear.
Really feel, Beast?
And,
you know how I feel, man. Just looking for a good time, baby.
What else can we promote?
This is this kind of a silly
question. Is it
question.
Difficult to work with him, Baker?
Who?
Do you find the Beast difficult to work with?
Who?
The Beast.
Oh, me?
You.
I am the Beast.
I'm Baker.
Do you find Baker?
Did they introduce us backwards? We're gonna have to start over. Man,
you guys gotta start. Jeez. You guys gotta get your stuff together.
So what do you do on your radio show?
They're not answering my question.
We do the same thing we're doing now.
It's where chaos becomes reality. It's a show that people listening must. It's a first in human history where you do a radio show and you have to shut up. You have to sit back in your chair or in your car or in your sweetie's arms and listen to the show. Come up. The show. We don't come down to you. You must come up. Up, Michael Stock.
I think what also sets us apart is we're one of the few radio shows that uses visuals. We do a lot of visual humor.
Right, that's interesting. Exactly. It's very important to have good-looking guests on the radio.
Very, yeah.
Such as your next guest. Your next guest, the Baboons, have been on our show. So, ladies and gentlemen out there, you'll
Ray,
see.
That Ray is a looker.
Oh, you have, oh, yeah. You have live guests. And,
every week, we've been on 47 weeks, and we have had 52 bands on. Local bands every week.
Sometimes we double up.
Are they local bands?
All local bands. Everything from blues, jazz, rock, reggae.
Stephen Mikus with the sitar.
Sitar on AM radio. No. Tawny Gill from the Willie Chirino Chaito band.
And then since you won't bring it up, I will. And I noticed your name in the paper every week doing something at Tobacco Road.
We do. We do
Pete's Wicked Night Out.
Wicked Night Out.
What's that mean? Well, who's Pete?
Well, Pete is
a beer.
A beer brewery, which you're not allowed to promo on this show. What's wrong with you, Stock?
Okay.
But we can't
don't
say
any more stupid questions.
Yeah, bang him! Okay. Basically, Pete's Wicked Night Out is every Thursday night at Tobacco Road.
He stole that. He stole that visual joke from our radio show.
He did.
You've been watching our radio show, Mr. Poe.
I haven't watched your radio show once.
That's right. We don't want you to either. It's on Tobacco Road on Thursday nights at 10 o'clock. This particular week, just to give you an idea who we're presenting, it's Charlie Pickett in the MC3 and...
Manchild, that's tonight. Soon as we finish here, we're going to run out.
There you go.
Yeah.
And they've been on our radio show as well. So what we're doing is we're showing the public that there is a viable rock scene here in South Florida, that we are presenting it at certain locations around town. A very interesting one is Tobacco Road, the oldest club here in the city of Miami, where Clark Gable drank. Mm-hmm. And Humphrey Bogart.
And me.
And me and Mark Weiser.
This show is going to, it's just taped, and we're not going to air it, I think, till September. But you're also putting together some other things. Churchill's is like a 300 rock band thing in the month of August.
That should be over about now, right?
Yeah.
We're
done. Right.
Wow.
That's right. It's all over.
Oh, man, I'm going on vacation because I'm exhausted.
It's not another stupid question.
It's the Miami Rock Festival.
400, we must have 500 bands, and... 10,000 people showed up each night. It was basically a Woodstock 2
for
the 90s.
Man, it must have been hard on you guys.
It was, but can you see
you
it? Look
fresh.
At this.
You
feel like it's just getting started. I feel like we're just booking the bands now.
Ladies and gentlemen, compost because, you see, this is a present because Greg Baker has quit the New Times and I was fired at WDNA by a pack of wild aliens from outer space and we are now also organic gardeners.
This is true.
So this is compost, which consists of 7-2-2. 7 phosphorous, 2 nitrogen, and 2 hydrogen.
Those are very low numbers.
Very low numbers. Well, we can grow anything from, anything grows in this, from weeds to squash.
What kind of weed?
We don't
grow anytime. Like sunflowers and dandelions and things like that. Uh-huh. And we also grow, our specialty is hot chili peppers of over 20 varieties and tomatoes.
So what is it you guys do?
We are basically,
sit around all
we
day.
Rule our own world. Unlike you, that's got to come in here with all this no thinking, drinking, or singing, or smiling, or anything, and we rule our own world.
Especially
in fact,
no
we're
going to
rule your world.
Especially
we will
no
rule the world.
I don't think so.
Unless we
I
run out
know
of time.
So.
I don't think
Unless
so.
Yeah, what are you going to do about it?
Here comes
the beast. I'm just going to have to come over there and give you an attitude adjustment.
Yeah,
wait.
Your dreams, you pencil neck geek.
I'll tell you right now.
What's your name, Elena or Alan?
Excuse me.
We play with
me.
The toys. Oh, sorry.
We only have a few minutes
Mr.
left.
Mr. Stock has a question.
And I would like to hear.
On my nerves, Mr. Stock.
I would like to hear your plan to rule the world, beast.
Well, all you got to do is look in the New Times for this issue, and you will see Pete's Wicked Night Out at Tobacco Road, hosted
Dude,
by the.
It's
by
the middle of September. Who knows?
It's
if
the
oh, that's right.
Still publishing.
Well, what we're doing is we're showing. See, the problem with Miami, as you well know, and everybody in this room, including you over there. Know that this city has the capability of pulling together in your particular genres, folk and jug bands and things like that. If we all pull together, if we all shut up, come on out to the gigs, pay your little couple bucks and support the local bands. Peace, in fact, remember Skipper Chuck Baker? Peace, love, and happiness. Let's go, ready?
Peace, love, and happiness. Everybody.
Peace, love, and happiness. You're a bunch of
we'll
dead
be right back.
Man, we ought to take over this show. We'll be right back with the Beast and Baker Show.
After this word from Pete's Brewing.
We want Majika in here right now.
Who?
Majika, you're going to see her right now. Coming up real soon, baby.
All right.
We have 2 minutes to go.
I've had enough of this guy.
Let's talk about the media
industrial complex. Rock bands,
let's talk about the media. About the media industrial complex and freedom of speech and expression in the United States, Poe and Stock.
No.
We are. We're part of the media.
Okay.
We are part of that media industrial complex, and we don't want to hear you talk bad about it.
Yeah, well, we're going to do it. You belong to a particular brand of the media industrial complex.
Yeah.
You are now broadcasting from the entertainment.
We're company.
Educational entertainment industrial complex, Poe.
You're going to guys
wrap
this up.
We don't want anybody talking trash about the media industrial complex because
we
are
up.
It.
We need to wrap it up.
We've got a couple issues in New Times so we can wrap this up.
Yeah, let's show the Playboy issue with Diana Ray in it.
Listen, I'd like to say thank you for coming here, but I don't know if I should.
Thank you. Thank you. Listen to Waxy 790 at 12 midnight every week, and we will show you the way radio could be. Right, Baker?
Should be. How much time do we have?
Okay.
About 1 minute. Wrap it up.
You're off the show. Get up. Oh, thank God we got those guys off, huh, Mr. Stock?
Yeah, thanks. Thanks to Beast and Baker for doing that.
Get up and really get that guy.
Yeah, well, good.
Throw him out.
At least now we can relax and settle down with our new guest here in the studio.
No, I don't think we're going to relax.
You don't think so?
No, I don't think so.
Ray Conga.
What Diaz?
What can we expect
from Hialeah?
From Hialeah.
The king of Hialeah.
A lot of musicians come out of there. Why? Warehouse City.
That's interesting. Sure, I never thought about that.
Oh.
I always thought because once they get lost and they can't find their way out.
I didn't know they had a king of Hialeah, though. I thought they had elected officials.
The Conga King.
The Conga King.
Well, the Conga King.
Yes.
Self-appointed?
Self-appointed, I guess.
Okay.
Well, Ray is here, but quite frankly, we're more interested in Majika.
Ah, well.
Why, Mr. Stock?
Well, the outfit, maybe? Hi, Majika.
Hi.
And welcome to the show.
You can hardly get it out, can you, Mr. Stock?
No, that's not true.
Remember, you're married.
Good thing you have a desk there, Mr. Stock.
Why do you call yourself the Baboons? Is that right?
Yes.
Is that accurate?
Correct.
Explain.
Well, the Baboons... Basically, the Baboon is the wisest and most sexual beast in the jungle.
That explains it.
Yeah.
Explains it.
During mating season, they appear to have red butts.
We've done
that. I've seen that.
We've done that on shows. We've actually
painted
them.
We have been known to paint our butts red and
do
butt solos, actually.
Butt solos.
Couldn't you show them?
Conga butt solos.
Yeah.
As percussion.
Really?
Slapping of the butt.
Oh, you're kidding. Is that right?
That sounds like an educational thing to see, wouldn't it be?
Well, I understand you have a video of it. Is that right?
We have a video.
Well, not of the butt solo, but...
No, but you see butts, but...
Oh, wait,
the tongue right. Okay.
So there's no butt solos on the video?
No.
Oh, well, that's
that you must catch live.
That you're going to do live right here in the studio, Mr. Stock.
Well, you brought a video.
Okay.
And so tell us, if it's not butt solos, what is it?
Well, it's of a song called Grind Your Hips. And it's based on the Miami influence, South Beach, different things that are going on. In Miami.
And what is this, a music video you made?
It's a music video from a lot of what we call was the urban tribal sound from South Beach, from the music.
Yes.
Joe Massat, director of the song we made, the same directed the video for us. He was down here. And I guess it's a lot about South Beach and what it sounds like.
Okay. Well,
this is a historical documentary kind of thing.
Yeah.
Okay. There's some documentary of the baboons.
Exactly.
Yeah.
No, well, South Beach.
Of South Beach.
In the history of
the baboons. All right. Let's take a look, and we'll come back to Ray and Majika.
Crazy Miami streets, 'cause I got this fascination for this part of the world. It's all its many cultures, it's all them pretty girls. And Miami has a funk that will tear the mother up, and it lies deep in the conga sound and the sun that never stops. She said,
grind your hips, you baby, sexy driveway, and sweat your daddy body, girl, 'cause it ain't going away. No, it ain't now. Grind your hips, you baby. Sweat you down your body, girl. See, ain't going away.
out my mate and call, picking up her scent. Hanging at the local bars with ones that I like best. So many variations, all sweet as sugar cane, all burning with desire. Cool back Caribbean rain, she said,
grind your hips, you baby, and sexy job way. And sweat you down your body, girl, cause it ain't going away, no, it ain't round. Grind your hips, you baby.
Walking on the beach, such a pink on the horizon. Only time I get to think how my city keeps on growing. Its colors are just showing. It's the fellow banging anger beat. Soothed by a suntan flare and a cool, sexy stare. The rhythm on her shores, the music in her street. She said,
"Run your hipsy baby, sexy John Wayne. Let's sweat you down your body, girl, cause it ain't going away. No, no, no. Run your hipsy baby.
My gosh, I can't believe we aired that on that Mr. Stock and Mr. Poe show. Certainly out of character for everything we've ever done before.
So yes.
So much sexual overtones there. And
great for the Beast and Baker. part of that deal.
And the Machika looked like you were having fun there, is that?
It's good that the Beast is not in here right now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I noticed that they were enjoying it as much as we were.
Yes.
It's like as though they were seeing it for the first time. It's like
we
a comedian
had a
still laughs at his own jokes no matter how many times.
Careful now.
Mr. Poe.
Are you hiding? Are you hiding behind all the stuff, Mr. Poe?
There's something about one of our guests that might be making me feel a little anxious, Mr. Stock.
Yeah, I don't know why it is, but I don't mean to insult you, Ray, but I don't feel like asking you any questions.
Okay, that's great. I'll just play the drum.
Okay.
Well, if you feel like hitting Mr. Stock.
Oh, okay. No, I'll just.
No, it's okay.
You know, down here.
So, Majika, when you sing, were you always a singer?
Well, I started out playing tambourine in the band, and then eventually shakers.
Something happens.
Then you fell in love with the band leader?
Is
that what happened?
One day, I just...
Something happened to her on stage one night, and she started to sing, and it was amazing.
It's a very nice, deep voice. It's a very kind of a deep voice.
Her speaking voice. Her speaking voice.
No, but you just... What do you mean speaking voice?
Her speaking voice.
Her singing
voice isn't that deep.
It's very
deep.
Is it deep?
It depends. It depends what song.
I can tell you're a deep person in general, but...
Right now we're in the studio and we're doing a reggae tune called Retrospect, which is going to be finished Sunday. And we're recording at Natural Sound, mm-hmm. and then Studio Center on the 25th and 1st.
And
as well.
And you, when are you going to make the video? I'm much more interested in the video, probably, than
the next video, or
than the
We're working on the next video soon, at with the CD coming out. We're going to work on that.
Okay, well, it's very interesting, seeing the South Beach on that video.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it was fun seeing it, but there was too many sexual overtones. All the bikinis and the dancing. It was just...
You didn't like it, huh, Mr. Stock?
It's just not right for cable access TV.
We tried to run a clean show here.
Yeah. Got it,
no,
but you...
Okay. Well, what I'm wondering is why... I understand you're wearing that loincloth you were wearing. You wore on a different talk show, but not ours. Why? Because you knew that Mr. Stock was kind of...
I knew that the Beast was going to be here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's very dangerous wearing loincloths near the Beast.
Mm-hmm.
He has this growl.
Let me ask you another question.
No.
When you, in the video, you don't have your glasses on. Do you have contacts in the video or you just go blind?
I go blind.
Is that right?
Yes.
Well, it must be easier to perform when you can't see who's
yes.
out there leering at you.
Yes, there's no stage
fright at all. Why would anybody be leering at her, Mr. Stock?
Sure.
You go like this, the way you were just looking at her?
No. But it's, no.
Huh?
I'm asking questions and you interrupt me and
I can't help it,
Mr. Stock. Where I'm going, Mr. Poe.
Well, you go ahead. Go on.
Well, you interrupted me.
No, go ahead.
No. Well, I mean, no. If I had to sing...
No.
If I had to sing in front of thousands of people in a loincloth, I'd like to be blind, too, I imagine. I don't want to see who's out there. And
why not?
Well, sometimes I do wear contacts, but other times it just depends on the mood I'm in, whether I want to see people or not. But sometimes it's dangerous, because if there's things on the floor mm-hmm. or whatever and you can't really see, it's pretty dangerous.
So you're not wearing shoes?
Well, I wear moccasins.
So is that
when
is
I wear
that,
the loincloth?
What other outfits do you have? I mean, who cares? What kind of question is that?
I thought that was one of the best questions
got
so
many
far
outfits.
Today.
Well, the video, that we saw, Ray.
Huh?
What happened to that video? What do you do with that video now?
We are shopping it all over the town. England has it. We sent it to England because we, like I said, the director is Joe Massad, and we are getting ready to finish our CD. Once we have that, then we have a lot more leverage to do. The video is all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
We're showing it off all over. We had our opening party at used to be called Prince Club, and
Glen's Club.
You mean the man that used to be? No,
used to be
Prince.
Called Prince,
and now he's sold. He's out.
No, it's called Glam Slam, but
yeah.
the former artist known as Prince.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You want to get a stand as good side now.
Yes.
So
that's actually where you shot the video.
Formerly, it's Glam Slam.
An amazing
musician.
Formerly
owned by the man who was formerly known as Prince.
Mm. Who cares about that?
Who is an amazing musician.
Have you met the former man who we were talking about?
No, but he does have a video of ours in possession.
Oh, is that right? Has he seen
his
it?
Collection.
I'm pretty sure,
yeah.
Well, you haven't heard one yet.
I saw Métis, his girlfriend, at the Santana show.
You saw who? I'm sorry?
Métis.
That's a woman.
Women with strange names just hang out together naturally, or?
Yeah.
Is that your real name?
Mad
Magica?
Well, it's my nickname.
That's your nickname.
Yes.
Is it kind of off magic, right? You're
magic woman.
You're a magic
She's
woman.
The magic.
What's your real name?
Michelle.
That's a pretty name.
That is very nice.
I like
very
that. Nice.
But I guess it's better to have
It's
Magica.
Good to keep that image, you know.
Well, is that a
Magica's
is that
nice.
Really you? I mean, is that image you, or is that more of acting?
Which image?
I think it is. It is me.
What's you?
Mm-hmm. No, it's her.
I'm more free and more myself, away from the everyday society.
Okay, you better stop. You better stop.
Let's talk to Ray.
To me now.
Talk
okay.
to the Congo guy for a while before you get.
Okay. Well, we just we have a few more moments left in the program, and Ray, this is actually a beautiful drum.
It's from Africa, and what it is a ceremonial drum. And what you do is, if you can tell, it's all one whole piece of work, and you put some bars through it. You flip it over on the flame. And it burns and it tightens and you can play it, which I do.
Are you
we do that at the
it,
show.
Or?
So
you guys are going to do a duet song. Now, right?
So that will be it's something like the Owa Dile.
Ooh, that drumming. I mean, I could feel that. That
so
mag,
tribal.
That,
it's so
yeah.
earthy. It's
oh,
so
yeah.
primitive, Mr.
It's yeah. heavy. It's good. We have all different types of drums. Just
it's
go to our shows
spiritual.
And you'll see them win.
Yeah.
Very spiritual. There's a very deep message behind what we do, and
what is the message?
In hoping to bring together nations of people and and unity.
How many people are in the band?
6 people, sometimes 7,
sometimes
8.
Different,
sometimes 15.
Do you count all the dancers as part of the band when they're there?
They're baboons. Baboons.
Okay. If you play with the baboons, you're a baboon at heart.
I just want to interrupt for a moment. We're gonna talk more to Alex and Majika. But I want to say thank you.
Alex.
Alex? Ray, I'm sorry.
Yes.
So I'm going to talk more, but I want to thank you. I want to thank everybody who's watching the show this evening for tuning in. What the hell with you? The band.
The heck with you. Dude, he's getting considerably... I notice you're not as prudish as you usually are.
Because the show's just about over.
He's loosening up for something.
Yeah, the show's just about over, so I want to thank you. But the band, the Baboons, where do you perform this red butt dance?
Well, we performed the red butt dance.
Ask him to perform it, Mr. Stock, so we can see what it looks like.
Yeah, see the red butt dance.
Can we see the red butt dance?
No, that's a special occasion.
You can play on the drums and... No?
You can do that? No?
I don't know if our mics are on here.
Our mics are probably on.
I'm sure they're on, yes. Yeah, okay, we'll continue.
That was a very special occasion at Churchill's.
It's not done that often.
A few weeks ago. It was actually only done once on my butt.
We did
bear butt? Is it a bear butt on your
bear,
pants?
Bear.
I painted it red, and I had shorts with holes in them. And my butt was pretty exposed. Mm. I bent over and the drummer did
Don't interrupt, Mr. Stock. And?
The drummer did a butt solo.